As you can see, I have a whole bunch of machines in here. I have my Kali Linux systems on this side. I have my Windows machine on this side, Ubuntu servers, and a whole bunch of other computers. There's gotta be a better way to manage your computers. Hey guys, I hope you're doing fantastic. This is Dan Duran, and today I'm going to show you the lazy way of managing your computers. So stick around, don't go anywhere, get your coffee, and let's get going. You can use one of these. This is a KVM switch, a keyboard, video, and mouse switch to manage your computers if you want. So you attach a whole bunch of cables in here and monitors and so on. The other thing that you can use is keyboards and mice and all of that on each computer. And all I have to do is just turn around and start working on them. But again, and I am too lazy to do that, so there is a better way. And that's exactly what we're going to go through today. I'm going to set up an RDP, so a remote desktop protocol connection made by Microsoft back in the days and can be used pretty much universally. So you can use an Apple device, you can use a Linux box, you can use a Windows machine. And in this case, we're going to use a Kali Systems to connect to the RDP. Okay, so I'm running my Kali Linux system in here, and I'm just going to log in like that, and I'm going to start a terminal, right? So let's start the terminal right now, and I'm going to go into sudo su, there you go, and type in my password, right? So I'm here. Now the next step is to install XRDP. So I'm going to go and let's check out if we have XRDP installed. So XRDP, and as you can see, is red, so it's not installed at all. So I'm going to choose no, right? And let's install RDP. So you type in apt install XRDP. There you go, like that. Perfect. Once it's installed, then what we're going to do is we're going to enable XRDP to on startup. And to do that, we have to update. So update your rcd.d like that. And I'm going to type in XRDP enable like that. Perfect. Once we do that, now we're going to start the service. So you type in service XRDP start. And let's check out if it's working. So service XRDP status. As you can see, XRDP is already running. So the next step is to create a new user for Kali. So let's do that. This new user that I'm going to create is going to be an admin user. And the reason why I'm doing this is because you cannot log in to an RDP connection using the same user that you already logged in with. So you need to create a new user. Kali in Linux, that's how it works. You can actually have two different users logged in at the same time in Linux. In Windows, it's a little different. You can only have one at a time. So if you log in with RDP into the Windows machine, it's going to ask you to log out from user one to log into user two using RDP. So let's create a new user on the Kali system. And for that, it's very simple. You just type in add user. So minus minus home. The home is going to be GetCyber. 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 And the user is going to be GetCyber again. Like that. Now it's going to ask me for a password. So I'm going to enter a password. That perfect. And name is going to be GetCyber like that, and then I'm just going to go through all of these. I don't have to put anything in here. And at the end, is this information correct? Yes. So I'm going to type in Y, and there you go. Now we're going to do something else. We're going to assign the sudo or the admin privileges to this user that we just created. So the way we do it is type in user mod like that, and a and then capital G to assign the group. And the group is going to be sudo, obviously, because sudo is the admin group for Linux, and cyber or GetCyber, which is the user. And there you go. So now let's try logging in with that user. Going to Kali system here, and I'm going to switch user and GetCyber. And let's log in. And there you go. So this is the GetCyber user. And if I go into sudo su, we see that root is working. So obviously, to make this work with RDP, I have to log out of this user. So let's do that. There you go. Now I'm going to log in with my admin account. So Kali. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do IPA just to see the IP address that I got to plug in on the RDP connection. And that's how you set up the RDP client on this computer. Now let's go back to my actual machine and log into this computer. I'm using the Microsoft Remote Desktop app for Apple. This is exactly the same thing that you do using your Windows machines. The only difference is that for Apple, you have to download it from the Apple Store. And for Windows, it's already part of your Windows machine, so you don't have to download anything. If you want to download it from the Apple Store, just click on your App Store and search for RDP. And there it is, Microsoft Remote Desktop. Right. So in this case, I already have it open, so I'm just going to it. This is how it looks like. Now let's set it up. So I'm going to click on the plus sign and add PC. And in here, I have to type in the address. So it is 10.211.55.4. And then a friendly name such as GetCyber demo or RDP demo, relate that, and then click on add. And now if you double click on it and click on connect, type in your username and then the password like that. All right. And this is what you see. You have to create a color manage device. So I'm going to type in password and all right. So I'm logged in. That's how easy it is. Now, if you want to set up RDP on your Windows machine, then that's very easy also. So let's do that right now. All right, on your Windows system, it is very easy. All you have to do is click on Windows, then go to settings, and then from here, go into remote desktop and make sure that your remote desktop is set to on, and then click on require devices to use network level authentication. With that, you are going to be able to log in to your Windows systems without any problems. And that's the lazy way of managing your computer. And this is not just confined to your office space, but if you are an IT specialist working at an entire company and you need to manage computers, you got to have a process where you use RDP to be able to connect to other people's machines. I hope you had a lot of fun with this video and try it out. Try the RDP. It's super simple to do on Kali Linux and it's going to work wonderfully for you. And I'll see you next time. Stay safe, stay secure.